What is that? Oh, Billy, I put this under the bed the other night while we were, you know. Okay. Hi, I'm Billy Rush. I produce Serge Gainsbourg's records from 1984, Love on the Beat, all the way through 1987, You're Under Arrest, and beyond. I was contacted by Serge in 1984 to make the Love on the Beat album. I had never heard of him before that point. In fact, everyone that I work with had never heard of him before in New York. The very first meeting, he came down to my home studio in New Jersey. It's a very modest place. And he came in and he didn't say a word. He was as quiet and very shy. Serge took out his dictaphone, little dictaphone recorder with some melodies on it. And I started working with the guitar and the drum machine and the bass. So all along while I was producing this, Serge, as each new song came up, would definitely translate for me the idea of what he wanted. Because again, he didn't have the lyrics, but he might have had a few. But the general feeling of the song was always whispered in my ear. And I definitely got the picture of what he was trying to accomplish.
No comment. Si j'ai quoi affirmatif et quoi d'autre, no comment. Peut-être dans mon subconscient, c'est venu de l'émission où j'avais brûlé ce billet de banque. Et ensuite, dans le monde, sans mettre mon nom, il y a eu un dessin avec une bulle affirmative, no comment.
Serge would always do, oh man, that's great, that's cool. That was his hand signals for, we know we had it and it's cool. So we took those hand snaps and put them in the front of No Comment. What a great way to start the song. And we put an effect on it that was really cool, that reverberated, an echo effect. And that was the beginning of No Comment, and it really set the tone for a really swinging groove on that song.
Si j'ai quoi, affirmatif. Et quoi d'autre?
No Comment.
Si je baise, affirmatif. Quoi, et non? Love on the Beat, c'est l'amour sur le temps, c'est pas à côté, c'est ça. C'est in. C'est je t'aime moi non plus en puissance 1000.
One special tune that Serge was very excited about when we were working in the project studio was Love on the Beat. And he goes into his briefcase and he brings out his little dictaphone cassette machine and he starts playing this tape is what sounded like, And I'm going, wow, what is that? Oh, Billy, I put this under the bed the other night while we were, you know. Okay. So that was the actual tape that ended up on the record, and that was our metronome, so to speak. We built up the track pretty much from the rhythm of that, and it was kind of a hard sound that he wanted to match it. And that's what we did. And that's the birth of Love on the Beat. Toward the very end, there was one track left, and that was Lemon Incest. And he goes, Billy, this is gonna be a scandal. This is gonna be a scandal in Paris, and he kind of gave me certainly his feeling and what he wanted to say and gave me a little bit of a translation of some of the lines that he had, a twist of lemon. So Charlotte did come down and Bamboo actually went somewhere to pick her up in the plane and brought her back because she's very young. She's 12 or 13 years old or something like that. And she comes in and she's very frail, very sweet young lady.
Je dis aux Américains, vous nous mettez deux micros et puis on va chanter tous les deux. Et quand j'ai entendu cette petite voix, là, la gorge se serre et je commence à pleurer.
Je t'aime.
plus que tout.
It took a 3-4 hour session, but and he was kind of hard on her. He bared down, but in the end, they were happy and they got what they wanted. And she went right out the back door with Bamboo and jumped in the swimming pool with my wife, Peggy, and our little son. So in the window of Finneck, I saw about 1,000 of these. And I said, okay. You know, I've seen, of course, there are other artists that had done dressed up in drag like this. Had changed over, but they were mostly those androgynous kind of artists that were very close on the spectrum, you know? Man, woman, and then they were sort of close. It wasn't a big stretch to hop over and dress up with makeup on. But Serge Gainsbourg, I mean, I always thought of him as he's like got this deep voice with a scruffy beard. This is a man who's way over here on this side of the spectrum. So for him to get dressed up, prettied up like this was really a stretch, and I thought that was a brilliant idea, and it was so beautifully done. He looks actually pretty here. You know, when you go back in memory, there's so many like highlights with Serge. There's so many like highlights that it really, in a way, wasn't that hard to remember because the feelings came right back of those highlights. I mean, being with him was a like a Ferris wheel of color, you know? It's like, boom, pops here and there. And so they last in your memory.